good day, everyone. My name is Cynthia. Happy Sunday to you all. I hope you went to church and you're back. I pray that the blessings of God that He has for us today will enrich us in the name of Jesus. Amen. Yeah, there is something I listened to this week. I think it was yesterday that I really want to share. It's about single mothers and why I love carrying some things about them is just because I happen to be one, and every stage of our life should be very, very important to us. I used to say that the Bible, according to the word of God, that God says He knows us by our name ever before we are conceived, which means whatever we may have gone through in this world, He is actually aware, and He knows that we will go through whatever we have gone through. And that's why I like talking about it. Yeah, I don't know how many of us are following this C4Chi. That lady is actually doing wonderful, and she's been bringing different cases that, you know, she would just call maybe the person will just call on her. She will bring the person to her wall. The person will like recount what has happened, and people will like be given advice, you know. Like yesterday's own really touched me, and it's about a single mother. That's why I want to talk about it. Yeah, this was a lady who says she was a single mom. She has a girl, and she's a single mom. And ranging from what she said, her business is actually going on very well. She's buoyant, you know. But there's this particular guy. I think he happened to be from the same village with her. They stay in Lagos. Somehow they met, and things became actually difficult for the man. It was where he was hovering around looking for help that he came across this lady. And to the lady, she's been a single mom with one child. She didn't want to remarry, but she wants to have another child, maybe just like one, to make them two, just to have two kids in this world. So based on the fact that she didn't want to get married, she just wanted to like have a friend that will help her have a child, maybe additional to the one she already had. So from there, the man will go his way while she'll go her way, taking care of her kids. So when they came together, she started helping this man. After the man recounted his problem, she started helping the man. The help actually got to the stage that the wife knew about it. So she was taking care of both the wife and the kids, and also the man. She even went as far as renting house for them, because where they were living, I think, according to her, she said the man owed for like 4 months, or maybe 4 years. So she helped and clear all the bills, started something for the man and also the woman, and also helped to re-enroll the kids in school, because like the kids stopped school at some point. So, but all the while they were doing it, the wife actually knew about it. She knew the fact that they were friends, but she didn't know that they were lovers, you know. And along the line, this man was like going deep. So maybe one way or the other, somehow the man took a nude picture one day. They were together like that, which the lady said she didn't know. So one day the man kept his phone carelessly. The wife picked the phone, went through the husband's phone, and saw the lady's nude picture that the husband took when the lady didn't even know anything about it. So the wife of the man now took the picture, forwarded it to her phone, and now forwarded it to a lot of people. You know, they like almost like out to blackmail her. So it was on that picture, the nude picture, that the wife now had to know that they were actually going, and that she was actually going out with her husband. So she didn't take it lightly. She started sending the pictures everywhere. The other woman started receiving like death threats, you know. And it went to the extent that she left Lagos for them, and now went to the east. She located to the east just to have another life, since they've already made her new picture there in Lagos here. So she had to relocate to the east and continued with her business. So, but on the even when she was already settled in the east, the other woman somehow came to the east one day and saw her. That was how she started the attack from the beginning, you know. Also brought out the nude picture that had already finished raining in Lagos. So she now brought the whole thing to the village, and that was when she didn't take it easy again. Then all the while she left Lagos, the kids of this woman were like crying, I want to see auntie, you know. So one day the father now linked them up. It got as far as she had to pick the kids of this woman to the village and started living with them. So the case now got to the stage that they had to go to the village to go to their king, maybe their traditional ruler. The king now talked about it and now advised the other lady to chill, that a woman that has helped you and helped your husband to this extent, I mean, you should chill, you know. But the woman refused to chill. So the king now advised the man, well, since your kids are already used to the other woman, and she has been so helpful to you, why the other woman was not doing anything for you, why not just get married to the other one? Since the other one, according to them, said she had threatened to leave the marriage, that she wasn't born to suffer, that the man was not bringing anything at home again. He drives one bus like that. So every day he would come up with him. He went out, he didn't see anything, he repaired bus, nothing to eat, and that she cannot continue to stay. So that was how the man heeded to it and got married to the other woman, why the other one actually left. Yes, I saw comments. I was also among those that was against the other woman's attitude. It was like she used their poverty, just the time they were going through hard time, to lure the man into marriage and forcefully force out the other woman from her marriage. Yeah, she even said what made her to even come with that complaint to see for she wall is because somehow at this time she was no longer living in peace with the other man. You got to say that the other man even had to hit at her one day, that the man was complaining. Anytime she scolded the kids for anything, the man would take it to be another thing. So she was just like, well, she knew she had actually made a mistake. She wants to what? Even if they would eat her, let her eat her. But then she wants to see for she advise her on what to do, especially now that the man has like turned against her. And the man was sitting there when she was telling everything. So she even said that the man was sitting there. See, first she now said he should give the man phone. He gave the man phone. The man confessed that everything the woman had said was just truth and nothing but the truth, but that the only one he did not take was the fact that he started beating, that this was the first time he was hitting her. And again, why she did it was because the woman was no longer as submissive as she was supposed to do, maybe because she has money more than, so he was like so stubborn. Whatever she takes decision without her, that there was without him, that there was a day the lady brought her father home. And in fact, like he told the man said he shouldn't do that, but the man went out and came back, met her father, and her father started staying with them. So many things he would tell the lady not to do, she would go ahead doing it. That if she stops being stubborn, the home will start being happy again. But where I'm going to is even this. I know we are single mothers. I know things may not be as rosy as we think. I know some of us may want to have additional kids with the ones we already had. I know that because you're a single mother, you wouldn't want to go to single guys, because not even all single guys want to settle with you. Every single guy want to like have his own family to start afresh, though there are a lot of single guys that will tell you that you're exactly whom he wants, but then it's not common. I also know the fact that somehow married men may be hovering around us, that they want to do this, want to do that. I think the only advice I want to give you as a single mother is this: if you know you want to remarry, set out yourself out that you want to remarry. I don't see reason why you go spending on a man that you already know that is married, he has family, just because things turned down for them, and you think maybe by doing that you could lure the heart of the guy. You know, now the other woman is out and you've taken over the home. But I'm just saying, if genuinely this man from the beginning liked you and now told you about a relationship, you could start going out, somehow it now resulted into marriage, you would have been exonerated from this. After all, men are polygamous in nature, as they used to say. So what I'm saying in essence is that it will pay better that you know you can no longer endure to stay as a single mother to take care of your kids, and then you can go get married. You can remarry. Even the Bible said it, that it is better to marry than to burn in sexual desire, and that two are better than one. Really, I've been a single mother now close to 10 years. I know what, especially not just any how single mother that wants to be going out, this a concentrated single mother that had no even friend. I know what loneliness is. I can tell you that it is not easy, but it takes discipline. So I am just saying it out. If you're a single mother and you know you cannot stay, just like the Bible says, that if you know you can stay to be a eunuch, you can stay. But if you know you cannot stay, it's better to get married than to burn a sexual desire. So if you're a single mom, instead of you to be hovering around like that or having different cases with different married women, it will pay you better to just accept one. If you know you want to get remarried to another man who is already married, let them make it open. Then legally, you will get married. So many people are married to more than one wife. In that case, you have your dignity, especially if the man is able to like keep you in a different place from where the other wife is. I think it will pay better. Then aside even single married men, I know there are still some single men that would wish to get married to you, though some of them are like somehow threatened that, especially if you've had one or two, they're like, okay, especially with the economy of the country these days, nobody want to come and incur responsibility of another man. So if you are lucky to see a single man to get married to you, I think it's okay. Or there are some widowers too, though they're not easily found. But before you think about getting married to a widower, also investigate what killed his wife. We are living in a world that we can no longer predict. If you want to get married to a widower, investigate what killed the wife before you choke your head, so that it will not be a journey of no return. Our people in Igbo land say that onye were kokos akoya oko abanar. If you want to take it because of loneliness or what you're going through, you need a companion, you need a support from a man, you may injure yourself, you may enter into a worse scenario that you are coming out from. Please, I am saying, I know it's not easy. I've been in it. It's not been easy. But I think being a single mother is better than being in a life-threatening relationship. And it's not everybody can endure this. I've talked with a lot of single mothers, so many others too, that are not doing anything, that depended on men solely on survival, as in this one will give you today, the other one will give you tomorrow. And that's how you're changing bodies. Sicknesses are so many in this world to be going from one body to the other. Physically, the person may look so healthy. Internally, the person may not be healthy. And think about it, when you're not having husband and your kids are under your care, you now die and leave your kids in this wicked world. Think about what becomes of them. So somehow we should be thoughtful. But generally, I advise you, if you're a single mom, I keep saying it, you cannot do this thing all by yourself without God. Even in churches too, we are single mothers. In our churches, I don't think there's even anything they marked out for single mothers. I could remember one last week they were preaching, it was family week. They were not telling single mothers, that your single mother should not stop you from even paying your tithe and offering. You have to be paying all those things, because the more you pay, the more you're sowing seed on the head of your kids. You know, I know nobody will ask even to reach out to you. I know the world has gone so bad that you won't even see anybody to hang out with, because every woman polices her husband these days that you will not even see any way to penetrate. And if you want to do it forcefully, you incur bad name. Before you knew it, your image will be down the drain. So it will pay better if any man is coming to you and he wants to get married to you, let him get married to you. Then for our men too, imagine you know that this lady is a single mother, and you people talked about it, that she stated it from, in fact, I've never seen a woman that is as open as that. She stated it that she really wants to get another child from you, but she didn't want to remarry, she just want to stay, which means she was not coming to destroy your marriage. And because of that, she started helping because things were not going well. Then you, the man too, you started overstepping. I don't understand what's wrong with some men. You know you're married and you want to have a relationship with a single mother so open, so that you put the woman into trouble. Good, marriage does not give us license to like go off completely from everyone in this world. That you're married does not mean you can't even be friendly with anyone. But in case you're a man, you're married, and you want to like have anything to do with a single mother, either to date her or whatever, please protect her image. Protect her image. She's also a mom. A child is already with her. And there's no man there. They want to take you as a father figure. You shouldn't like capitalize on it and spite her. I'm just saying to our men, if you must go out with a single mom, please think of her image, protect her. Don't make it open. I mean, I abhor all these men that will be married and they will want to make a relationship with another man so open. What do you intend to achieve? And you know the nature of our country. Women will war against women when they find out something like that. No woman goes to fight her husband. Rather, they will come and be fighting the poor woman. And the other lady too, you didn't think before. How can a woman go as far as doing all these things for you without you thinking to why that there may be tendency that your husband is going out with this woman? Even if she's a good Samaritan, somehow we should be thoughtful. If you weigh this case, it's true that where I commented, they actually blamed the other lady. But come to think about it, all of you are at fault, both the married man, the wife, and also the single mother. Please, let's be just thoughtful and have mercy on single mothers. If you must go out with a single mother, please help her. Just be a companion that she's looking for, not to like take it to your home. How can you be a married man and you'll be taking the nude picture of another woman? And some will tell you, no, my wife does not even go to my phone at all. You are saying that because you've not faced crisis. This is a world whereby some people will sleep and they will not wake up. This is a world whereby some people have faced crisis and slump. From there, your wife will start checking your phone. Before you knew it, they will be attacking themselves. Why are you guys doing this? If you know you're a married man and you want to marry more than one, state it openly. Tell your wife, honey, I want to go get married to an additional wife. Because I know one country like that they even stated it so open that a man must marry more than one wife, because there was crisis in that land and they killed a lot of their men. So they now stated it that every man should get more than one wife. So in this part of the world, it was not stated. Even in our own religion also abhor it. But then if you're a man and you really want to go beyond one wife, state it open. Let the other woman know and let your wife know and let the single mother or any other woman you're coming to. That's why till tomorrow I still respect somebody like Ned Walker. I don't know how. One is that he knows he needs more than one wife. Each wife he has, he legally married them. If you know you can take care of more than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's your pocket. Then you know how to make them live in peace, since you're not going to pack them in one house. Everybody will have his own respect. They say respect is reciprocal. Please do not hurt anyone at another person's expense, or make one to enjoy at another's expense. It will not be nice. Please. The Bible says, let everything be done decently and in order. One more, emebukwana one mother. One mother, emebukwana one more. Then for the single mothers too. Before you take bold steps, see, I don't know. You must not be married for you to be fulfilled in life. And peradventure, you cannot survive alone, especially in this part of the world. Openly get married than bringing shame, reproach, and disgrace to you and your child. I pray God will help and take care of us and make things work on our good, because it's no longer funny, especially at this present time whereby feeding have become so suicidal. No person you look for help from now. It takes Lord Almighty for you to even have any help from any man without any condition these days. But I urge you to be strong as ever. I urge you to give it all up to God. I urge you to be closer to your God. That's the only solution and the only hope you will have to survive in this your journey of single motherhood. It will not be easy. Nigeria is thinking about our culture. Men actually take the lead. And it's so bad that a man who is married, or ordinary man, cannot ordinarily hang out with you without any sentiment attached. I pray that the Lord Almighty will give us that one that will understand us, that one that will not put us into trouble, that will really come to be a companion that we actually desire. In the name of Jesus, amen. I've been praying for us. No wonder, it's not knowing why Tonto DK took it as a cause to help single mothers. She had been in it and she knew what it entails to be a single mom. Her own is even a different case because she has everything she needs herself. Unlike many of us that are still rigmaroling. But I still believe that a living dog is still better than a dead lion. It's better you are alive and single than that you are in the hand of somebody that will just take your life in this world. May God settle us. May God have mercy on us and settle us. And wipe away our tears and give us somebody so thoughtful and kind that will come to clean our tears forever. Amen. God bless you all. Have a beautiful day ahead. Cynthia, Kes, love you all. We are in this together, and together we will keep praying for ourselves till God answers us. Have a beautiful new week. Bye for now.